A note on precedence. A lot of things come up during Zap when you don't really know what to do, you don't know where the rules lie, and then you try and look at decisions you've already made based on those rules and where things fall, and that precedence determines your decisions a lot of times. It's just like law, really. And so tomorrow, we're gonna do something that I would initially say would be illegal during Zap, which is using my dad's truck to launch a kayak. But I really don't see that that's that much different than getting in a car with someone with my fishing spool, which is also a tool, and driving to the beach to go fishing. So even though it's something I think that you'd probably have a hard time doing in the apocalypse a year in, maybe you'd find a running vehicle, precedence is that for the experiment, we're gonna let it slide. So I got this weird idea that the last week of Zap, I wanted to go kayaking, which is something that I really had planned to do this whole time, and it just never happened. So Cyrus and I are leaving 5 days on the kayak, and we're just gonna head south and see how much ocean we can cover. So I've been packing, and it's like, what do you bring on a 5-day backpacking kayak trip? Especially when you can't go to the store and just buy a bunch of like really easy food to bring. So here is my piles of random ass stuff that we'll be going backpacking, kayak packing with us. I hope I've got enough food. Paddling all day. On some acorns and some goose meat. We'll see how that works out. I'm pretty much gonna get back from this kayaking mission and go straight into the last night of Zap, so I slaughtered one of Jenny's chickens. She's gonna finish Zap out of chicken debt. This really is kind of my last meal of Zap, besides whatever we can scrounge on our trip, but this is my last nice meal I could make myself. I gotta say I'm a little nervous about this whole kayaking trip. I'm constantly worried about calories and energy and whether I have enough food. It could either be like the most amazing, best experience ever, or it could be a freaking total disaster that just explodes in our face and we can get stranded anywhere on the Big Sur coast or swept out in the ocean or God, who knows. Hopefully the weather's good, not too much wind, not too much swell.
Alright, we're going, now or nothing. Now on to phase two, white capping ocean. All right, so we're gonna turn left and go about 60 miles, right?
That way.
Okay, that was really gnarly. We launched right into all those white caps and surf right on Pfeiffer Point. Just got nailed. The secondary orange kayak just kept flipping and I was jumping off our kayak, re-flipping it over. And we tried that one with Cyrus just in it and this other kayak that our buddy loaned us. This pretty much sucks. So we're gonna try and regroup, get everything on one kayak. I felt like I was on one of those like I Almost Survived shows. Like I was off this point, there was surf surging, the wind was going, the kayak was flipped over. We actually flipped our kayak at one point, oh my God. We have resituated everything onto one kayak and we're going to launch. So far we have made it about a half a mile of our 60 miles.
That point is where we started, way back there. So we're making time. This might actually happen. We're about a mile out, it looks like, at this point. That point down there is about 40 miles away as our next, like, kind of waypoint. All right, Cyrus, just keep rowing. I'm gonna hang out.
There's nothing quite like the hilariousness of bringing your primitive fire starting means and then capsizing your canoe, dry bag collapsing, and you pull your baseboard out and it's actually soaking wet along with everything else. So we had this out in the sun for about an hour. I'm gonna see if I can get some fire. Otherwise, our fish is gonna have to be sushi. Apparently the bow drill worked out after all.
had extreme tragedy upon our canoe. During the unsuiting process, I saw Cyrus's hat got knocked off, so I grabbed it. And then I realized that when I had unsuited, my hat was gone.
It is of note that I totally forgot that I'm really, really susceptible to seasickness. And I was basically puking all over myself today. And I'm so glad to be on land. That's only day two, holy shit. Wind came up bad. It's white capping. Once again, it seems I've over-romanticized everything. And the kayaking, backpacking has moments of absolute blissful, amazing awesomeness and moments of really, really sickness. Or like when we came into this beach, we yard sailed and pretty much just got pounded in the surf. Oh, there's apples all over the beach. I found it interesting that one of my sources said, if you hold your hand out at sunset, tuck your thumb in, your hand's extended as far out as you can get it, then each finger from the horizon up to the sun is about 15 minutes before the sun sets. So when I'm looking at this right now, it's about three fingers. So it should be about 45 minutes before the sun sets. Let's see how long it takes.
I'm guessing about 30.
All right, the sun has just dropped below the horizon. Let's see how long it took.
30 minutes exactly, dude.
Really?
Some trolling while we're out here. Well, we caught some kelp for a little bit, but the trolling does not seem to be working for us. I'm gonna have to go back to spearfishing. Alright, day three. The ocean finally calmed down a little bit. We had a pretty awesome day of kayaking, actually. And also, we just made the sunset spearfishing session. In all truth, it was kind of like going to the grocery store. I just put on my suit, went out there, picked two fish, shot them, and brought them back. It was awesome. Here we have our fishies I just shot for dinner, and I just realized that the smaller one has something in its mouth that maybe we can eat. Oh, look at that. Calamari.
Very fresh. It's really good.
Straight from the fish's mouth. Here's something interesting that I learned on Zap, which is that a full moon will always set at sunrise. And besides this, a full moon will also always rise right at sunset. Which, you wouldn't think this could be useful, but it was really useful last night when I kept waking up and I'd be able to look at the moon and know how long it was till I had to wake up to go kayak.
Well, that shit. Bam!
I had a realization this morning, which is that I miss coffee more than I miss beer. Only 3 days till I can have a coffee. Son of a bitch. deer god today. We had to do a double leg because there was no beach where we thought there would be a beach. So we just kayaked like almost 20 miles. I thought I was gonna puke most of the way. That means that we're a day ahead. And this is our final destination, 60 miles south of Pfeiffer Beach. I may never set foot in a kayak ever again. In fact, I need to learn that I love the ocean, but it does not love me. And we've yard sailed every single landing. So we're gonna see if we can finally make a clean landing on our last day.
I know, we made it.
We nailed it.
And we're a day ahead. 4 days. How do you feel about this, Cyrus?
I feel accomplished. I feel like my honor is intact.
I feel very fucking seasick, dude. Oh,
I'm proud that you didn't puke this time, dude.
Dude, I thought I was going to puke for the last hour, dude. I was just sitting there like,
I was waiting for it.